Please come.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Please sit down.
Thank you, sir.
Have you come to last year here?
No, no,
sir, I have been in the planet.
That's right. I saw you.
Mr. Tarunjali,
sir.
You are from Esmeralda district.
Yes, sir, my mother is from there.
So your hobbies are long distance running, half marathon, public speaking, trekking, adventure sports and everything.
Yes, sir.
So this looks very impressive. Tell me, since you have adopted them as your hobby, how would you inspire me to adopt those things as my hobby?
Sir, can I zero down to a particular hobby, sir?
That's up to you. Because you have written so many, I told you that.
Yes, sir.
So you zero down and say whatever.
Sir, I would take long distance running as the hobby. Sir, I would pursue you to also run long distances because it is very good to help in the first case. Physical fitness also helps us to be mentally stable and mentally fit. And in the era of cancers these days, I think running is very essential for one to maintain a very healthy lifestyle. Also, sir, running is not just about physical fitness, but it also helps me especially immensely mentally, because it makes me a more mentally stable person. And also, while I run, I set targets and I break them, so they give me a sense of achievement and fulfillment also, sir. So I think you should also try it, sir.
Is there any scientific link between cancer? If I regularly run, it will be a great preventive against cancer. Is there a scientific proof or evidence to that effect?
So not just running, but exercise definitely slows down cancerous tissues or cells in the body, sir. So the toxins in the body are moved out by exercise. So I think running definitely has a link to slow down the process of cancer, if at all one has it.
On three occasions earlier, you couldn't qualify in the prelims.
Yes, sir.
Is that so?
Yes, sir.
This time you have made it.
Yes,
sir. You have qualified in prelims and mains. Yes, is the final. Tell me why you couldn't qualify earlier and what you did this time to qualify.
So honestly speaking, I just attempted prelims out of random, but I haven't prepared for those attempts where I didn't qualify for prelims. One time I got qualified, last time I got All India 488, that was my serious attempt, sir. Again, this is my second serious attempt coming into examination.
So you were just non-serious and now you are serious, and here you are not.
I just took chances, sir. I mean, I didn't prepare fully for those attempts.
Mr.
Tarun,
the trekking is a very good hobby where you are into Himalayas and Westerners.
Yes.
Can you list out some of the differences what you observed in Westerners and Himalayas?
Sure. Sir, Himalayas are much difficult terrain to trek. They being more taller, altitude wise also, than Western Ghats. Himalayas are much colder. The extreme topography is different from Western Ghats. Western Ghats, the average height would be somewhere around 1600 to 2500 meters. Like Himalayas, I have trekked till 5000 meters, height of 5000 meters. Also, Western Ghats, the treks are only for 2 to 3 days maximum, sir. Whereas Himalayan treks are much longer, ranging from 7 to 9 to 10 days also. So, endurance wise, Himalayan treks demand more physical strength than Western Ghats.
Okay, Western Ghats are rich resources of resources for India, whereas Himalayas are not. Can you list some of the important resource Ghats that are present in Western Ghats?
Sir, resources in the sense?
Mineral resources.
Sir, in Western Ghats, So Western Ghats have coal resources. Apart from that, I'm not sure about any other mineral resources.
Where are the coal resources? Do Western Ghats have coal?
I presume so.
Okay. These two are mountains, right?
Yes.
Western Ghats and even Himalayas also. Then why they are called as Ghats and why they are called as mountains?
Sir, if I may guess, sir, with your permission. Sir, I think Western Ghats are called Ghats especially because they do not have much altitude like Himalayan mountains. I think for a mountain to be qualified as being called mountain, I think it should have particular.
Aravalli, sir, more than height of the Western Ghats?
Yes, sir.
Aravalli, sir, more than height of the Western Ghats?
I think so.
Yet
sir,
they are called as mountains, they are not, in fact. Yet they are called as mountains, but whereas Western mountains are not called as mountains. The call is Ghats, why?
I'm not sure.
Okay, good. And can you talk about the society of West Godavari district, since you are from sociology background?
Yes.
How it is differ from the northern society?
Yes. Sir, West Godavari, if we take the basic demographics into consideration, the female ratio is 1,003 to 1,000. 1,003 females to 1,000 men. Also, the literacy rate is 75%, which is more or less equal to national average. And there used to be prevalent child marriages in West Godavari, at least 30-40 years back, but now with stricter legislation and awareness among citizens, they have been reduced. Also, basically, West Godavari has a lot of farming community where they cultivate paddy, coconut, sugar cane, etc. I think this is all I can remember.
What are you doing now? Are you in government service or private?
Yes, sir, I am in government service.
Customs.
I work as Deputy Commissioner for CGST and Customs in Hyderabad GST Commission.
Okay. Then, what is this Business Development Executive?
Sir, that was my earlier job profile while I was in corporate. I worked in a company called VMN for 3.5 years as business development executive.
Okay. I'm looking at your educational graph. It's very interesting. You got 91 in 12 and 64 in VTEC. Very surprising.
So if I may say, the highest percentage in VTEC during my batch was of my college was 82. So generally they don't.
I don't believe. Getting 9 plus CGPA or is so easy in engineering if you are serious. That means you are not serious in your engineering. You just score 64 is how much CGPA? What percentage is this? How do you convert it?
Sir, we did not have CGPAs back then. Sir. It was called 64 in first class.
This is very poor performance for a BTEC graduate.
Sir, I do accept it, sir, but.
You're not interested in the BTEC?
It's not like that, sir. I was interested. But then somehow I couldn't score much marks like my 10th, as I said, because the scoring system was different in BTEC.
Explain. How it is different?
Sir, in 10th and intermediate, the correction is more liberal where getting 90% was much easier. But in BTEC, getting 70 to 75% is almost equivalent to 90% of 10th and
intermediate. Who said that? 64 is 64. 86 is 86.
Yes.
You are telling you are equating yourself with 64 with 86. I don't think it's not acceptable.
Sir,
there has to be some reason for deterioration of academic performance during BTEC. You have taken biotechnology.
Yes, sir.
Is this anything to do with the subject or the college? You are from some private college.
Yes, sir. Sir, I don't think so. The college has influenced my marks, but in general, I don't score much as I scored in 10.
What could be the reason? That's what I'm asking. You are telling the same thing. Your biodata speaks the same, but you have to validate why. There has to be some valid reason for your performance in BTEC.
Sir, I don't know, sir, it just happened. I could not think of any reason for my low marks in BTEC.
Your father is from Khammam?
Yes,
mother is from.
Yes. Father is from Khammam.
Okay, now just tell me after this bifurcation. Then suddenly the TRS government is in support of special category status to Andhra Pradesh. So what is your view on this special category status? What is this all about?
So special category status was earlier given to 11 states based on the
list of the 11 states.
So from ranging from Jammu Kashmir to Northeast.
No, just tell me, you've taken 11 states, what are they?
Jammu Kashmir.
Yes.
Uttarakhand.
Okay.
Himachal Pradesh.
Okay.
Sikkim.
Okay.
Arunachal Pradesh.
Okay. Six.
Five. Nagaland.
Five. Nagaland. Six.
Manipur.
Manipur. Seven.
Mizoram.
Eight.
Meghalaya. Tripura. And Assam.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead.
So sir, they were given the special category status on the basis of certain parameters where
like
the states have hilly terrain, they have to have international borders.
Are you sure? Okay.
Yes sir. And then the economy is very unviable in those particular states.
Okay.
And a certain amount of tribal population is also taken into consideration, sir.
Okay.
Sir, Andhra Pradesh was never guaranteed a special category status in the AP Reorganization Act as such, but the government has been demanding because it's
hold on. The Prime Minister of India, Dr. Manmohan Singh, has declared the floor of the Rajya Sabha on 21st December 2013.
Sir.
You said that it's not there in the Act.
It's not there in the Act, sir.
But he gave the promise, he promised on the floor of the Rajya Sabha.
I'm not sure about it.
It is, that's
sir, thank you for reading. So, but then they are demanding it because it's a sunrise state. It needs a lot of funds to establish itself. But
are you in support of it or against it? What is your view on this?
Sir, I don't think it matters now because all the provisions earlier which were given to a special category state, most of them have been removed.
Are you in favor of it or against it? Yes or no? Are you in favor of it or against it?
Sir, I am in favor of it if the government gives it, sir, but as such, I am telling you.
You said that the criteria adopted for this 11 states, doesn't qualify, but you say that it is, how it is possible? You are self-contradicting yourself.
No sir, I mean to say because this is a very new state, it's a sunrise state, maybe they
it
can
has 900 make kilometers of coastline.
Yes sir.
You have shipping and marine resources.
Yes sir.
Tourism. The existing criteria, it doesn't satisfy, yet you are in favor of it.
So they can, maybe they can tweak the provisions a bit and maybe they can give it.
Then what about the Bimanu state? What are the Bimanu states?
So Bihar, Madhya Pradesh.
They are worse than AP.
Yes. So but
I also you are also tweaking this provision so that it can be extended to all other states.
No, I didn't mean that, sir.
Yeah. Okay.
But as such, the special category status, even if it's given now, I don't think it would benefit the states, sir, because most of the provisions of special category status have been removed, sir. Like earlier, there used to be the special central assistance of 100% to these states, but now that has been removed, sir. And there used to be.
You know where? For the special category status? States?
Yes, sir.
It is removed, are you sure?
Yes, sir, it is removed, sir. Because
it's a news to me. I'm from Meghalaya, Assam, Meghalaya, Kata. It is still there, 90%, 10%. It is still there.
They have stopped giving these grants.
It is, I am telling you, it is there in Assam, I don't know about other states, Assam, Meghalaya, it is there. 90-10, special category, it is there. Because the conditions which laid down still remains, hilly terrain remains, backwardness remains, international border remains. Nothing changed on the ground. There is nothing in the hands of government of India to change the status of these, any of these states, but you said that it is scraped. Very interesting. It's a news story.
That's what I came
where,
across.
Where did you came from? You have heard about this news.
I've read it in
the news. You are factually incorrect. You have to verify your facts.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
You are working in GST.
Yes, sir.
Who is the ex officio secretary for GST Council?
Ma'am, I'm not sure.
Okay. Recently, Manipur mob lynching law is a news.
Yes, sir.
Can you explain the law?
Ma'am, the definition of lynching has been made more specific in the Manipur mob lynching law. Also, I think there are stringent provisions against people who are lynching.
Can you explain the features?
One feature I can remember is there is no provision for an individual inciting mob, but there is a provision for groups which are inciting mob.
What's the punishment they
I'm not sure about the quantum of
punishment. You don't, I'm not sure. So, if not the law, what is the permission for punishing a criminal who got some law lynching? What is the provision in India? Where it is located? Provision. Where it is mentioned?
No, I'm not sure.
Do you know IPC?
Yes.
Which section of IPC?
I'm not sure the section.
I'm not sure. Can you define what is artificial intelligence?
Artificial intelligence relates to the capacity of machines to emulate certain human actions.
Recently, NITI Aayog gave a report. India should become a garage of artificial intelligence. Can you tell your recommendations, how should we make India a garage of artificial intelligence?
I think the first and foremost thing is to enhance the R&D capability, also streamline enough funds and resources towards artificial intelligence. Also, young talent should be encouraged to work towards artificial intelligence. I think we have been doing well in this sector, and I think more emphasis is needed to make India a garage of artificial
intelligence. You have done your graduation in biotechnology, BTech biotechnology.
Yes, ma'am.
How do you relate this artificial intelligence to biotechnology?
Ma'am, biotechnology is the process where human genetics and other life systems are used for human welfare. So, the bioinformatics is a field, I think, which can connect artificial intelligence and biotechnology. So, with the use of bioinformatics, I think the biological processing systems which are being conducted now, I think it can be taken to the next level where it can match artificial intelligence and can be used towards human welfare.
What is DMH
11
technology?
DMH 11 is the Dara mustard 11, which is basically the GM mustard, which was envisaged to be cultivated in India. But then there were apprehensions because it's a food crop. The approval is still not given in full scale. So there are apprehensions regarding the utility of GM crops.
What are the crops in India that got clearance from GESC with respect to GM?
It's genetically modified cotton.
Okay. That's all?
Yes, ma'am.
No
other crop? I'm not sure about any other non-food crop, but there are no food crops which have got the permission.
What are non-food crops that have got
permission? I'm only sure about GM cotton.
Tell me something about your dad's profession, Deputy Director of Prosecution, sir. Spelling mistake is there.
Yes, I'm sorry, sir.
It's interesting.
Yes.
What is the job profile of your dad?
Sir, he retired as Deputy Director of Prosecution, where he was a public prosecutor, grade 1. So, he is the custodian of the victim. He represents the state. He conducts a trial. From the moment a charge sheet is launched, he conducts a trial and he hears witnesses, he briefs them. So, he also aids investigating officers when needed.
Your attorney is custodian of victims and he aids the investigating officer both.
He definitely gives advice to investigating officers as and when needed.
In what sense you are saying that he is custodian of victims?
In the sense, he represents the victims.
He represents the victim.
Yes.
By mistake, you use the word custody.
Is there any law specially for witness protection in India?
There is one law which was envisaged, but I don't think it's full-fledged. I think it is under making.
It is under making.
Who is Vagdevi and what is her significance?
Sir, Vagdevi is the goddess of speech. Significance, but I'm not sure, sir.
Tell me about Indo-African relations, or for that matter, foreign relations, any country, which you love to talk about?
Sir, I would talk about Indo-African relations. Sir, India has very good relations with Afghanistan, as in it has contributed up to $3 billion till date in Afghanistan, where it has helped in building Sarma Dam and then Afghan parliament, it's also gave so much of humanitarian assistance to Afghanistan. There are also cultural ties, cricketing ties with Afghanistan. We have a long history of cultural ties with Afghanistan. The government and the regime there is under trouble because Taliban has control over most of Afghanistan, and in the recent news that US is going to pull out its troops from Afghanistan, I think India has to tread cautiously wherein it has to protect its installments and infrastructural investments in Afghanistan, along with being open to talks with either the government or Taliban.
What's the significance of opening library in Afghanistan?
I'm sorry, secondly.
Significance of opening library in Afghanistan by government of India?
Sir, it helps in developing the educational profile of Afghanistan, but I think apart from library, we have also developed a lot of other infrastructure in Afghanistan.
Before you go, just I want to enlighten myself. Tell me one important governance issue of today and explain what it is.
Governance issue, sir.
Yeah. One most important governance issue of today.
I'm not sure.
There should be some. Okay. You tell me one social issue that agitates minds of everybody in this country.
Sir, when it comes to social issues, there are many, sir. Like, I would like to emphasize on child marriages, where it's been there from past many years as a culture and as a part of Indian tradition. But there are stringent laws towards child marriages, but still child marriages have been happening in rural areas, especially because lack of awareness and lack of education. I think there has to be a multi-pronged approach to child marriages, wherein legal interventions, attitudinal behavioral changes, and other changes have to be brought in. The government is taking right strides in eradicating child marriages by implementing schemes like Beti Bachao, Bachpan Bachao, and the Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana, etc.
Okay. How do you think that you have done in this Mukherjee?
Sir, so the interview is over. I'll get out of that zone. I think I'm not satisfied with my
performance. When you are this side, you are not very satisfied. You are not that side, you are not satisfied.
No,
what exactly will you do?
In the sense?
What exactly will you do to prepare yourself for that?
Sir, I would like to develop more on my profile, and I think I will also have to do some rehearsals, like talking in front of the mirror, recording my voice and listening to it. I'll try to be more specific to certain questions.
There's no problem in your voice. You are doing good.
Thank you.
No problem is with your
content. Anyway, when we meet next, we'll discuss all those details. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.